Hi everyone, it's Chelsea here, bringing you another segment of Living in Southwest Florida. Fort Myers has been growing in leaps and bounds. Even US News ranks Cape Coral Fort Myers Metro as one of the fastest growing cities in the country. And in many ways, over the pandemic, it's felt like that pace has gotten even faster. If Fort Myers is on your radar, then you may be considering if it's the right fit or not. So today we're going to explore whether or not Fort Myers is the right fit for you. But before we get too far along, it would mean a lot to me if you could go ahead and hit that like button so that YouTube algorithms share this information with others and it lets me know what you'd like more of. And as always, we love helping people from all over the country buy and sell their homes here in Southwest Florida. So if you or anyone you know of are even thinking about moving, then feel free to use that contact information below. All right, let's jump on in. If you've been debating a Florida move, the beaches are likely a big motivator. And while there are beautiful beaches all over the state, here in Southwest Florida, we are known for some pretty special ones, combined with our slower pace of life. For starters, Sanibel Island and just a tad north of us is Siesta Key are both consistently ranked as some of the best beaches in the world. But not to be outdone, we also have Fort Myers Beach, Lover's Key, Barefoot Beach, Del Norwegian State Park, and many others that are worth exploring. And location-wise, we are hard to beat. For starters, we have an international airport, so travel into the area is easy to get in or out. But also, we are situated between two main hubs, Miami and Tampa, which are respectively 2 hours away, and Orlando theme parks are only 3 hours away as well. So this allows for close amount of amenities, but still living on more of an island time. Speaking from personal experience with our own move, when we came back from a large city, we felt like we had left a rat race, so to speak. Which leads to another thing about the lifestyle on the Slow Coast, the lifestyle. Many people move here for the activities. Boating is a way of life for most people here, and fishing is a big passion. Golfing and tennis are coveted pastimes, and even nature walks, camping, and equestrian events are often part of life here in Florida. There's many pools to go swimming in, and as you can tell, we often find ourselves outdoors. Which I'm sure you've heard about our weather. Yes, Fort Myers does get really hot in summer, and we get a lot of rain. Expect a thunderstorm every day around 4 p.m. in the summertime, and it'll be hot and muggy for those summer months as well. The good news is that most of the year the weather is gorgeous, and the months that it isn't, we have swimming pools, air conditioners, and water sports to help cool us off. And with wet weather comes mosquitoes. We definitely have our share of bugs. You can probably randomize a Florida Living video and find someone talking about the bugs, but most places have bugs. And real talk, is that really ever a reason why someone decides to move or not? If you think it is, tell me below in the comments. I'm curious if it's a genuine factor. For us, it's just a part of life, and you get used to living in screened patios or wearing bug spray. What is a real factor is the financials around it. This is a growing, affordable city. I've mentioned in the past that according to payscale.com, which does monthly data collection, the cost of living in Fort Myers is 4% less than the national average. But what I haven't really compared is the statistics around other Floridian cities. Cities like Miami, which is 14% higher and obviously more expensive, but also lesser known cities like our close neighbor Sarasota is 9% higher, and even St. Augustine are all above the national average. But in general, Florida is a relatively affordable state to live in. There is no state income tax, homestead exemption taxes can help offset costs, and housing is still relatively obtainable. According to the National Association of Realtors, the median house price is $385,000 for the nation. And here in Southwest Florida last month, our median sales price was $358,000, making the Fort Myers Metro incredibly affordable. The last one I honestly hesitate to add as a real factor in decision making, since this is constantly revolving and changes with the literal topic of the moment. But I cannot deny that I've heard often over the last year or two that people's motivation for moving is politically driven. We all know that life during the pandemic has been polarizing, and Florida's stance has been national news. That may be a factor that'll bring you here, or maybe a factor that you'll use to cross it out, but it is a factor to consider. I will say though that no matter your political affiliation, there's a community here that thinks like you. I have friends and clients on both sides of the aisle and can confirm that no matter what your voting record looks like, you can find your people that you can connect with. All right, I hope this helps you with your decision-making process. I think I hear most often the beaches, the weather, and the lifestyle is the top three, but I do hear politics and financials thrown in. Are there any specific points that you're considering that help make up your mind? If so, please leave them in the comment section below and I will address them honestly. Or if you'd like to post questions more privately, you can find my contact information in the video description below. And once you're ready to explore the market and see if this is the right place for you to live, then feel free to use CapeCoralFortMyersRealEstate.com for all the latest listings to hit the market. Every week I drop new content on my social media, so be sure to follow me as well there to see what life in Florida looks like. And be sure to hit that like button, subscribe button, and notification bell so that you get all new content. So with that said, thank you very much for watching. I really appreciate it. And until next time, I wish you much health and happiness.